They're here now, so yeah, I've got to go.
Hey, welcome back. In our previous tutorial, we showed you how to get the best results from your webcam footage. Today, we're looking at how to optimize Zoom to record your calls. We're then going to be jumping into HitFilm Express for a quick overview on how to trim out those unwanted moments.
Ollie, you're a mute. Ollie, you're a mute, mate.
Hey.
Yay.
Nailed it.
We're going to be doing this using completely free software, Zoom and HitFilm Express, so you don't have to spend a penny and can follow along if you're doing live streams, podcasts, meetings, or just catching up with family. Let's begin. Begin by opening the Zoom application. You can download and install this from the Zoom website, link in the description. When we're logged in and ready, head over to the gear icon to enter the settings. Once in, let's enter recording options. There are two ways to record in Zoom. One is locally, so on your laptop or desktop. The other is cloud-based, storing your files on an online drive that you can then download later. In this tutorial, we'll be looking at the local-based as it's included in the free version. So first up, where would you like to save your files? Use this tab to choose a location on your laptop or PC for the recording to be found once completed. Alternatively, you can select this option to manually choose a location after the meeting has ended. The next option is to record audio separately for each person who speaks. This is a great feature because, as we mentioned in our previous tutorial, audio is so important because this also allows you to have complete control over the situation and avoids any overlapping.
Right, any questions?
No, I would say, absolutely.
No, go ahead.
What?
No, you go first.
No, it's fine. No, you go.
I forgot what I was going to say, so you go.
There you are.
Very important for what we'll be doing later, optimize for third-party video editor. We definitely want to tick this. The next option, timestamps, will apply a date and time of the recording, though this is something that we could do in HitFilm. If your meeting will require some screen sharing, enable this option to allow those reviewing the call later to be able to see what you're all talking about. Finally, keep temporary files. Let's say that you're doing a tutorial, for an example, and the Wi-Fi cuts out. Well, this feature allows you to have a recording of everything up to press, meaning that you haven't lost that entire session. Last thing that we can do before entering the call is enter our video settings and make sure that Enable HD is active. Now we can go ahead and exit our settings and just jump into a new meeting. As the admin or the person who set up the call, I have the ability to record this down here in the options or by pressing the shortcut Alt and R. If you are with other people that may need to do the recording, you need to assign that to a participant in your call. You can see that I'm recording in the top left-hand corner here. I also have the ability to pause and stop this recording at any time. It's important to note that once you actually hit stop, your video will not be converted until the end of the meeting. This will be converted into an MP4 format for you, so you can then use it in anything that you like. This does also mean that if you start and stop again, you will be creating two separate files. In your display settings, we recommend that you record in active speaker view. This will make it easier on your editing process and keep the attention on you and your colleagues presenting. Now that the call has come to a close, I will end this meeting and wait for the conversion to complete. A new folder will open with all your video and audio files. Alternatively, in the Zoom app, you can go into Meetings and then Recorded to find all your previously recorded meetings and where they're located. Now we're set to jump into HitFilm. Now we have an excellent HitFilm Basics Masterclass to learn all the tricks for editing and getting the most out of any video work. Though we'll be going over a couple of key basics right now because you're a busy person. Okay, with HitFilm open, we want to first open a new project. For ease, we can stick with the default settings. Our timeline will actually be able to alter and adapt to our import. So let's bring in our footage using the import icon, go to our file location. Or you can open the file window and simply drag and drop your files. Once imported, drag your footage into the editor timeline. As we went for the default, we now have a prompt informing us that our settings are different from the footage. To remove this in future, enable Remember My Choice and select Yes. Make sure to also bring in and align your audio files. We have this beginning of the video where we're getting ourselves prepared.
Okay, yep. And I am now recording. Great, cool. So,
I want to cut this out in order to get to the main bulk of the meeting. There are two ways to go about this. Number one is simply by using the trimming tool and set the clip to a new duration. Be sure to then drag this clip to the beginning of the timeline. Alternatively, or for moments that are taking place in the center of the recording, we can use the slice tool. clicking either side of the moment and then hitting delete on the keyboard. Now switching back to our arrow tool to close the gap. As in our Zoom settings, we enabled separate audio recordings. We can use those to maybe silence any overlapping audio or interruptions.
For our next tutorial, we could probably look into something with a bit more like Marvel stuff.
Hello. I can talk.
Now we could mute the channel altogether by either deleting the section as we have previously done, or we could keyframe the audio to dip quieter for that time. Hold control over the audio level to bring up the target. Place two keyframes before and after the moment, and drag the line in the center down to lower the audio level. Now you're clear from the distraction. With our recording cleaned up, let's export this out. Select the Export tab and head to Add to Queue. This will bring us to our export window. In this tab, we can set the file format. HitFilm has a collection of presets for all social media platforms, but if in doubt, you can't go wrong with YouTube 1080p. Click the name to set the title and location to save, then hit Export. You've now successfully recorded and edited your Zoom call. Thank you for joining us, and if you have found this useful, please do hit the like button and subscribe to the channel if you haven't already. If there is something that you want to learn in future, do let us know in the comment section down below and we'll be sure to add it to a future video. Hit that notification bell so you don't miss a single upload, and we will see you next time.